George is in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, listening on the app, the Catholic Answers Live app. George, thanks for downloading the app onto your phone. Go ahead with your question for Joe.
Hello, Cy. Hello, Joe. Thanks for taking my call, as always. My question is, there's a surging popularity of dating shows that have sort of a theme of expedited engagement and getting married at the end and it being this big dramatic thing. And my question is, are those marriages valid, or would that be grounds for annulment if you were to get married on one of those shows? And maybe as a second follow-up, is it sinful for me to watch those since it's kind of mocking a sacrament? Thank you.
No, that's a really good question. I don't know enough about the shows themselves.
Marriage at First Sight, The Bachelor. I can name all. I can name.
I was gonna say I'm impressed. Exactly the word I would use.
But are there any others, George? Can you name some of them?
Love is Blind is sort of what I'm thinking of, where they don't even get to see each other, and then they get engaged, and then they're allowed to see each other, and then they marry each other, like, I don't know, 3 weeks later or something silly like that.
Let's see. Canonically, there is a duty for pastors to engage in personal preparation to enter marriage, to dispose the spouses to the holiness and duties of their new state. This is in Canon 1063. And so that's definitely not being done. I don't think any Catholic priest could or would participate in this show. And so that's, you know, a Catholic better not be going on that show expecting to get a sacramental marriage in the eyes of God, because that's not how that's going to work if they're just randomly marrying someone they've never met before, especially in a way that does kind of feel like a mockery of marriage. That, you know, it seems like the whole point is this is a shocking and outrageous sort of thing to do to this lifelong decision. And there is something that I do think is kind of gross and mocking about that. Now, I've admittedly not seen the show, so I don't feel completely qualified to just say, like, no, you shouldn't watch it. But if they are demeaning and mocking marriage, which is already in a really bad state, then there are probably better things you could spend your time doing. I think that's probably safe to say as a bare minimum. So in terms of validity of marriage, let's say it's two baptized Protestants, so you don't have any of the canonical questions you would have if it was Catholics who are required to, you know, marry in the church without a special dispensation and there's personal preparation, all of these things. I think you could have a valid marriage in those cases if both people went in with a clear and well-formed conscience and had the freedom to say yes to this, because marriage is actually a fairly low bar. Now, it's a low bar we often don't clear, but the freedom to marry, it's worth remembering that unlike the other sacraments, marriage existed in a natural form prior to the coming of Christ. As far back as you go, very primitive people have gotten married. We don't know of a culture that doesn't have marriage. So humans are able to contract marriage, even humans who are maybe silly and stupid and reckless. Being silly, stupid, and reckless doesn't preclude you from being able to get married, thankfully, for some of us. And it can, at the extreme, it can compromise your ability to marry. But the mere fact that you maybe make bad decisions doesn't automatically invalidate your marriage. So I would say I'm not ready to declare null all of the marriages on those shows, but I would say one should certainly not participate in those shows, and you could probably find better things to watch.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this Catholic Answer, be sure to like, subscribe, and check out our live streams Monday through Friday, 3 to 5 p.m. Pacific, or find the episode after on YouTube, your favorite podcast platform, or our Catholic Answers app.